morning, everyone, and welcome to the Morning Metaphysical Report. My name is Lysander Xanthus.
And I am the Kitchen Witch.
So today is January 18th, 2020, and today we are going to be sharing with you the day's astrology, numerology, and some other things to bring you in, to bring into your spiritual practice and to help you engage your practice today. So this morning we're going to begin with a little mini grounding and energy clearing. It's always a good thing to do every single day. So wherever you are, whether you are sitting, standing, or moving about, getting ready for your day, you can do this. Just bring your attention to yourself and to your breath, or in the moment to whatever it is you're doing for those of you preparing for your day. And imagine yourself inside of a large bubble. This bubble is your aura. Now at the bottom of your aura, imagine a pipe gently attached to the bottom, going all the way down to the center of the earth. For the sake of simplicity, imagine that your bubble is full of a dark colored energy. Now, as you breathe, imagine in your mind that level, like that color, kind of draining out through the pipe in the bottom of your bubble. Just watch that level go down. So we're going to take a moment to do that. See it in your mind and feel it. All the layers of your aura throughout your entire body, all of your chakras, all of the heavy negative energy emptying out, draining away. All energy that does not belong to you. All energy that is not serving your true will. All energy that is not serving your highest good. Of it cooling at the bottom of your bubble and then draining out and down. You can use your hands and then gently move your hand below as if to close the drain, just see it disappear. And you can imagine the pipe just falling downwards or curling downwards or just disappearing down into the earth. So it's that simple. You've all grounded for the day. This is a great thing to do each day to kind of start from a fresh place. I'm going to do a little clearing now using this singing bowl. And for those of you who are just sitting or lying down, you can so breathe in and then push out with the breath and just think of whatever it is you want to release. Great. Now we are in an open, receptive space for our day. Over the course of this morning report, you will receive a mini healing, so we'll be putting energy back in, and at the end, I will be casting a protection and setting an intention for your day ahead. So stick around. If you decide to exit out, make sure that you shield yourself and bless yourself before you go through your day.
Fantastic.
So now it is time for the astrology of the day. Alright, so the Sun, Jupiter, Saturn, and Pluto are in Capricorn. So still, for those of you who have been watching still and for a while yet, throughout most of this year, we are going to be continuously encouraged to be the leaders of our lives, to get organized, to make decisions about what it is we want for ourselves before things have worked out, before it's clear how we'll get there. You need to make the decision and then figure it out. Mars is in Sagittarius, so we have a drive right now to discover what is possible for us and to look beyond the way things that have been. Mercury is in Aquarius, so the way that we think, the way we express ourselves, and the way we communicate with others reflects those qualities of innovation, doing things in a new and different way, perhaps being inspired with unusual ideas, and thinking in a way that is outside your norm. And this could be a great thing to help you make this shift that Capricorn is asking of us all. The Moon is in Scorpio, so we are feeling, we may be feeling quite emotionally intense at this time. We may have intense dreams. And so this can express itself as feeling more in our bitterness and resentment. So it could be good in that because you're feeling that more, you're more aware of where it is you need healing and release. On the positive side, we engage our deeper passion and power to transform at this time. So when it comes to doing magic to improve ourselves or to create inner transformation, the Moon in Scorpio has a powerful energy to assist you. Uranus is in Taurus, so this revolutionary planet encourages us to make changes that affect us deep in our consciousness, and to get outside of our comfort zone and to break up our habits, to get rid of old ones, create new ones, and just do something different. Venus and Neptune are in Pisces, so there's a part of us that's very much in deep waters, and in our love life and relationships, we're seeking depth and sincerity, but instead, we may be caught in illusion and fantasy, seeking what isn't there or that can't be had. Alternatively, there's an opportunity for a very deep intuitive connection with another person. Neptune and Pisces, our own deeper intuitions are rising to consciousness, so it's easier to be more aware of our own instinctual feelings at this time. Let us look at the aspects for today. So the Moon is sextile with Jupiter. So Jupiter shows that we can create opportunities for ourselves by exercising those Capricorn traits of self-sufficiency, being a leader, and solving our problems rather than waiting, just ignore them or waiting for them to go away. And with the Moon in Scorpio, connecting us to our depth of power and transformation, you can use this to kind of seize the moment, seize the day, as it were, and to push yourself forward. So you're intensely connected with how it is you really feel and what it is you really want, whether or not you believe you can have it. The Moon is in Triune with Neptune. So along with our deep, intense feelings and being connected to our power and ability to transform. This is accented by Neptune and Pisces, so pay attention to your intuitions if you're not sure how to create transformation for yourself. You may find something that your intuition is pulling you towards. Mercury is squared with Uranus. So Mercury is in Aquarius, Uranus is in Taurus. So being squared, there's this interesting dynamic of Mercury wants to create changes and do different things. Mercury can be a bit on the surface and quick and not really go deep. Uranus in Taurus wants to take that change and make it deep and all the way. So this can be an interesting conflict, and that you can be tempted to be impatient and to want to make all the changes now, but let it sink in and really root itself in the depth of your being. If you clear all the way down, not just out here. If you create a change, don't just let it be in your consciousness. Try to root it all the way down in your heart and spirit. And that is the astrology for today.
Fantastic. Sounds like a lot of let it go.
So next is the numerology for today. It is a 9-day. This 9-day is positive. It is a day of personal satisfaction and ambition. Release all things that no longer benefit you. Those bad habits, ideas, relationships that are holding you back. Let go of past wounds and step into this next cycle ready to fly. Today is also a great day to clean your house, remove all things that no longer serve you, and donate them, especially if they have negative sentimental attachment.
Absolutely. One of the best things I ever did, and the best thing I think you ever did, was we read the Marie Kondo book, Tidying Up. And in her book, she doesn't just talk about how to organize your home. What she's really talking about is taking a moment to look at every single item you own and assess whether or not you have a positive sentimental or positive association or attachment to each object, and then encourages you to remove anything that does not make you smile, basically. It's probably one of the best things I ever did. I got rid of things that made me think of my ex-husband. I got rid of things that made me think of, you know, past friends who had moved along. I got rid of things that reminded me of really difficult times in my life, whether it was clothing or, you know, objects or whatever. So yeah, it's good advice. Get rid of things that don't make you happy. If it doesn't serve you,
right?
If it doesn't serve you, if it doesn't make you smile.
So, yeah, that kind of reminds me of the thing with energy. In manifestation work or working with the law of attraction or doing magic, something we talk a lot about, or at least I do, is how we don't allow ourselves to have good. When good arrives, we tend to push it away, but it's like you need to take it. And we do this even literally with objects.
Yeah.
Keeping things that don't make you happy
is holding
or that make you sad is like holding on to stuff. And when you have all this stuff, there's not room for more things that actually bring joy when you look at them or use them. And if you have so much clutter, you can't enjoy the things that you like that you do have anyway.
Yeah, absolutely. All right.
So now it is time for our crystal healing. So now we are going to put a little bit of energy back in. The crystal we are working with today is called pediersite. When our new camera comes in, I'll actually bring the crystal up to you so you can see the details, but Even if I did, you would not be able to see it very well. 2 more days. So, known as the Tempest Stone, it has a highly charged energy that is almost tangible. Just as lightning clears the air and makes all things new, Meteorite discharges negative energies and emotional turmoil and cleanses the aura, restoring it to calm. It activates the sacral and solar plexus chakras, as well as the third eye, creating a powerful increase in the energy of personal will and intuitive abilities. It grounds the body's physical energy centers. Something I've learned also working with this stone is that it increases love of all kinds, especially self-love and self-compassion, as well as compassion for all humanity. But you are going to experience the energy of this crystal for yourself. So if you would like to participate in this crystal healing, just allow yourself to connect with the energy of the crystal. And I will begin. To place this gently on your third eye, which not only stimulates the intuition but the mental part of your being. Throat. The energy of this crystal wants to heal and to re-energize. Heart wants to refill what is depleted. It almost like burning away dark energy off the body. Anything that is left, especially off the shoulders where we hold our burdens, it's just like evaporating. And your spirit, your soul. Solar plexus, sacral, the root, there's a lower chakra that I work with that's like pertains to instinct and the earth. You're going to draw a circle, connecting back in the crown. Creating a sense of cohesion and wholeness. Radiating the energy of your soul outward to fill that space. And just a little beyond that. Connecting your divine connection to the universe and your earthy connection to this world, drawing in sustenance from both. The crystal healing with Pedersite. Let us take a moment to sit in the healing energy that we have received. If possible, it's always best to not rush off right after you've taken in an energy. Let it settle and integrate itself. Space, we are going to move into our affirmation for the day. So today's affirmation comes from the book Heal Your Body by Louise Hay. And this affirmation is for pain. So even if you aren't in pain, it is still useful. So I would like to state this affirmation to you first, so you can take in the words, and then we will say it together a few times. I lovingly release the past. They are free, and I am free. All is well in my heart now. We are going to say it together three times. We're going to do it slightly different today. Before each affirmation, breathe in, bring your hands up to your chest, and then as you say the affirmation, bring them out, and as you speak, you exhale while you talk naturally. So breathe in, and then we'll say the affirmation, and imagine releasing out through your hands. I'm not actually going to release out through my hands because I don't want to project that energy at you. So mm-hmm. I'll be doing it just as a visual guide. I won't be releasing myself, but you do that through your hands.
Get comfortable.
So I'm going to be using my hands. Thank you. I lovingly release the past. They are free, and I am free. All is well in my heart now. I think you guys can do that too. Breathe in. I lovingly release the past. They are free, and I am free. All is well in my heart now. One last time. I lovingly release the past. They are free, and I am free. All is well in my heart now. Maybe a few more times. How do you feel?
I think you could do it maybe two more times. How do you feel?
Yeah. All right, so twice more. I lovingly release the past. They are free. And I am free. All is well in my heart now. I lovingly release the past. They are free, and I am free. All is well in my heart now.
Beautiful.
And if you'd like, I will keep this on screen another moment so you can write this down or note the part that worked for you. And you can do that whenever you'd like. You don't even have to use this affirmation per se, just breathing out and releasing with intention can really create strong changes for you.
Is here to help you heal and release.
Yes, sweetheart. Yes, sweetheart.
She does. Yes, Rush adores Lysander. Adore.
Oh, I love you too, little cat. All right. It is now time for our magic tip of the day. And I feel like it's oddly appropriate, even though I wrote this tip down like a week ago. So it's less of a tip and more of a mini discussion. And the gist of it is, my magic / spiritual tip of the day is that you can exchange energy and create energetic connections and relationship cords through the internet or other electronics. So even if you don't know someone in real life, or you're not around them in person, you can still exchange energy through the internet, through videos like this, obviously, or even just through Messenger, through chat, through phone calls, through texting on your phone. It's just engaging with another person at all can open you to that energy exchange into creating a connection. And I bring this up, this isn't always a bad thing, you know, it's good to create connections, but it's worth being aware of, because a lot of times we're focusing a lot on letting go today. So let's say there's a person or some relationships you want to release. And whether you're just trying to get their energy out of you, or you're trying to do a cord cutting or what have you, a lot of times people will do that and they'll just not see that person in person or avoid them, but they still like talk on the internet or text them on the phone. And then they wonder why the cord reforms, or they experience problems or feel kind of ill, because when you cut a cord and you don't actually give yourself time to recover fully away from that person, reestablishing that connection can be very harmful to you. So be mindful of that. Cutting off contact with a toxic person means in total, not just you didn't see them in person. And also, it's important to be aware of that you exchange energy with people even through the internet or over your phone, or through the TV or through video, because you need to be more mindful of who it is you're engaging with online, over your phone, through the TV. It's funny, years ago, I had an online correspondence with someone, and from the moment that we started talking regularly, things in my life got really chaotic. It was insane. And I figured out that it was because of the energy I was inviting into my life from this person, so I just stopped talking to them and energetically pushed them out, and now that I was no longer feeding that energy into myself in my life, it stopped like as soon as I stopped talking to them. It's really wild. So a rush can call.
Sorry, babe. I know you're used to sitting on the desk with me. I'm sorry.
Oh, she's scratching my shoes now. That's her kitty vengeance. So.
Kitty vengeance. Sorry. Not like trying to change the topic. It was just funny. But.
So be aware of that. Really consider who it is how you're choosing to engage your energy with when you're using technology. I mean, you should do that all the time, but we tend to be more mindful in our face-to-face interactions than we are via phone or internet. Be aware of it. Those online arguments are energetically miasmic and negatively potent. Do you really want to step in that? You are connecting with all those people in that argument. This is more relevant for, like, those of you who have online friends, or again, you don't see those toxic people in real life, but you still have contact with them. Be mindful. So that's the magic tip of the day. Alright, so next we have a card reading.
What deck are we using today? I'm so happy to say that yesterday I took a dear friend of mine to go get her very first tarot deck, and she got the Doreen Virtue Angels tarot cards. Beautiful deck, very detailed. And so she was learning to work with those for the first time ever. It's always such a magical experience, especially if someone shares it with you. It's so nice to be there when they're getting their first deck and taking that step on their own path. So I'm very, very excited to be a part of that. I just wanted to share that. It's always nice to share that. Well, we're going to talk, Sandy. We're going to talk.
I'm not sure which deck to choose, but I got an image of an eclipse in my mind, and eclipses always make me think of a few different things. So there's a strong energy right now, and so the message of that image is a strong turning within, shutting out illusion, shutting out, for lack of a better term, romantic lighting that makes things look better than they are. Tapping into your own power instead. Sometimes you need to shut out, separate from your sources, even your spiritual sources, from the people around you, to shut out all that extra influence and just be truly alone. That may sound strange for us who engage our spiritual path actively or passively, is that being connected to our guides or deities or other spiritual sources is a big thing. This suggests separating from all of it, a quiet time. I'm not sure if this is voluntary or if we're being shut off from it on purpose, so that we have to really be with ourselves and face the truth and really acknowledge the reality around us as well as within us. Today's card reading comes to you from the Psychic Tarot Oracle deck. This is a reading for the collective. To give us insight into ourselves and the day ahead. So let's see what it is that we need to know today. I just got an additional clairvoyant message for you all. else that comes to mind with the eclipse is letting your intuitive ability sleep on purpose. Something I do occasionally is shut off for a few hours or a day. Ironically, engaging your spiritual abilities, especially if they're chaotic, can distract you from your emotions, from your thoughts, from how it is you're really doing and feeling, your issues and patterns. So turning off that influence temporarily can also help you get clear within yourself of what's going on in you as a human being. So we have one card. Jumping into the window.
Whenever Rush jumps on this desk here, everything goes crazy. Why don't we just start with this one, it looks like.
Yeah. So, material and what changes? What's the number of the card, Rob?
Financial and material changes, card 5.
Financial and material changes. The whole book is a guidance section, so I will pick sentences that stand out to me as well as offer interpretation. This card represents changes, challenges, and losses, usually related to material or financial concerns. You may be losing some of the things around you, but you must acknowledge and know that that besides existing as a physical being, you're an incredible and resourceful spiritual entity. Everything changes for a reason, and this time isn't meant to be a punishment. Know that your current conditions will transform for the better. A positive question to ask yourself now is, what did I learn from this, and how can I avoid it in the future? Now, that's what stands out to me. There are changes. And some of the things will be moving out of your life. We're going through a period of shedding of the things that aren't really conducive to our true natures. And it's not a punishment. It can feel like we're being singled out and, you know, poor me, and why does this always happen to me, and things never get better. But the thing is that these are the natural consequences of all that has come before. The natural result of your choices, or of you not making choices, depending. The key to liberation from your situation and from your issues is to understand and accept how your choices, or your decision to not make choices for yourself, have led you to your present position. Once you understand that, that is what you have learned from the situation, and that is your lesson that you can carry forward. So when you really understand and accept that, then you have empowered yourself to step forward, to make decisions that will take you somewhere else. Rather than creating this again, making decisions to lead you to something different once you understand that relationship. Some of you may not feel like your choices have led you to your current position, so sometimes it can be difficult to see your own responsibility, and sometimes that choice manifests as us having not made choices, either letting life decide for us, or other people decide for us. So that's this. If anything, if you'd like to explore anything that comes up in this reading more deeply, I do offer private readings. I am a clairvoyant reader. If someone requests, I can do a card reading, but that is my default mode, clairvoyant. So feel free to message me directly about that. Let's see if the cards have anything else they'd like to share with us today.
The camera keeps believing that I'm trying to correct a Russian attack from earlier.
It is a cat.
It was a cat attack. It happened. No amount of taping down my camera seems to help.
I think this is the last. That's all it has to say. It's few cards, but many words. Spiritual strength. This card is coming forth to give encouragement and remind you that you have the inner strength to complete whatever you've been working on. This card represents courage, discipline, stability, and persistence. You may be tired or weary from the struggle, but now is not the time to give in. Let's see. Seek things at this time to feed your spirit and to develop your ability to approach the future. This is a time to dip down. It's like a joke from a show we watch. But it's the idea of delving to the very deepest, most secret part of yourself to grab that gold nugget of spiritual power and harness it and take it for yourself to create transformation. You have what it takes to get through this situation, to create what you want for yourself. It's there in you. Just because you've forgotten it and lost touch with it doesn't mean it's not there. So you need to really go deep, dip down, kind of like imagine sticking your hands into the deepest cauldron all the way to the bottom to grab this tiny speck of gold. Scalding the crap out of your arms. So it may not be pleasant, but it is power and it will transform. And on the other end, when you start taking your power back and that vitality you've locked away back, it creates wholeness and healing. Even if the process is painful. Excuse me.
I'm glad I still have the card back.
All right, so that is the reading. Some things to keep in mind.
Few words, but very powerful words.
All right, so again, you know how to contact me if anyone would like to explore any of this more deeply.
Yes. So now we're going to move into my new segment, which is fun and interactive and involves all of you, which is our question of the day. So each day I'm going to come up with a question that's relevant to the things we've talked about throughout the show, and kind of have a brief conversation or a sharing point where we can talk a little bit about these things and
Great. I don't know.
I know. So. It's my thing.
All right.
So, the question of the day is, since today is all about release, what will you commit to releasing right now?
Right now. Not later today.
Yes.
Not tomorrow.
So I'm asking all of you, for those of you who would like to participate, the question of the day, what will you commit to releasing right now? If you empowered yourself, got up from wherever you're sitting to watch the show right now, and said, I'm going to release this. This is what I'm letting go of. It can be an object, blackout, high or resh. It can be It can be an object, it can be a person, it can be a habit, it can be a thought.
Sweet.
It could be a negative belief.
You're a beautiful girl. You're a beautiful girl. Yeah.
Let's see.
You're a beautiful
Sandy
girl.
Says
yes.
She commits to releasing any engagement with petty arguments. That is a fantastic thing to release.
That's awesome.
That is awesome.
Sweet.
Anyone else like to share? What will you commit to releasing right now? Lysander, what will you commit to releasing right now? Nilla says she commits to releasing everything that's holding her back.
Indeed.
Iris says, I commit to releasing the defensiveness in solitude. Wow. That is so well said. What a fantastic thing to release, Iris. Yes.
Especially doing releasing work yesterday, so it's just continuing to release blame.
It's a very important thing. Something we're all so prone to. Iris says, this speaks to my Catholic inner child. It's like a Lenten sacrifice. Yes, a little bit, isn't it?
Yes. It is, I find that a useful ritual, especially when you don't just give up some nebulous thing like candy or the traditional thing is like red meat, but actually giving up poisonous habits, things that keep you from away from God or from whatever divine source you choose to adhere to.
See,
part of my family is Catholic.
I think everyone kind of comes from some kind of background in that realm. At least nowadays, it just seems to kind of be the case. I commit, been thinking about this all morning, amen to blame. That's right, Iris. Releasing blame. I am going to release the temptation to engage in other people's negative thought patterns.
Yeah.
I don't need to be a part of their negativity. I don't need to encourage their negativity. I'm not going to engage with their negative thought patterns anymore.
Yeah. It's actually inspired by you to work on that as well. So, like, really, I'm always talking about the idea of, like, you're in here, everyone else is out there, but like really in a sense of like your divine presence and power, like I'm just going to exist here and not allow things to intrude on it.
That's right.
But also offer others that same respect and not force yourself on others in that way.
Yes. I can keep my negative thoughts to myself, but more importantly, I'm not going to engage in their negative thought pattern. We all have those friends that are like, oh, I feel so terrible about myself. Oh, I'm so awful. I'm so this, I'm so that. And you end up sitting there saying, no, it's okay. No, you're not. No, whatever. And reassuring them. And all you're doing is buying into that negativity. Mm-hmm. You're just getting sucked into it because they want to hear
the
compliment. They want to.
Speaking about defense, it's very powerful when you don't intrude on others because that doesn't create openings for others to intrude back. So it's just as important to watch yourself as it is to keep others in their place.
Absolutely. All right. Well, thank you, everyone, for sharing in this question of the day. We really appreciate you guys getting involved with that. I'm really excited about this little segment. I think that it's a little bit thought-provoking and kind of prompts us all to taking action in our day.
Alright, so the last few things are announcements and then casting a protection and setting an intention for the day before we go.
So we're going to say the announcements and then there'll be one more spiritual thing going on. So, announcements, let's have it.
If you enjoyed watching the Morning Metaphysical Report today, please like, follow, or subscribe to my page or channel, depending where you're watching this, so you can continue seeing it each day, as well as the other content that we produce, which includes psychic reading videos and guided meditations, and discussion of different metaphysical topics. This free content is possible due to support from viewers like yourself, so if you would like to help support the continuation and growth of the Morning Metaphysical Report, please visit patreon.com/freedomdreamcoaching to find out how you can become part of the magic and learn more about us. There are a lot of changes coming as well. We're going to be making some shifts, but it's all to make the machine run more smoothly, to offer you more value, more change, and more transformation. So it's all good stuff. After this report ends, the book club will begin in a few minutes. That was a segment that used to be part of the report, but it's been separated now. So if you're interested in hearing about intense self-help material, join me for that. And I think that's it. Do you have anything to add?
No, not at all. Obviously, just a reminder for those of you that would like to continue reading our book, All Is Well by Mona Lisa Scholes. The book club will be...
I just said that.
Oh. Somehow I missed you saying that.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, y'all know.
Okay. So...
That's it.
So, next, I am going to be casting a protection around you to carry with you through your day. Obviously, it wears down eventually, so if you tune into the Morning Report every day, you'll
stay
be
protected.
Solid. and then after that, we will be setting an intention together for the day. So, I will recite an intention, and you can accept that into yourself, or you can say something for yourself that you'd like to create in your day. This psychic shielding is very important to do every single day, especially if you are a practitioner. You're always engaging and working with other people's energies in an intimate way. So, you don't need to do anything special, just kind of be, whether you're sitting, lying down, or preparing for your day. And just allow yourself to receive the protection. I send my blessing to you and to your day ahead. There is one power, which is the source of all things. And because we are from the source, we are a part of it, and its power is our power. And all the things that we desire for our day, may our day also be filled with power, with prosperity, with good fortune, clarity, and true transformation towards our potential. Because all of these things come from source and we're part of it, we already have these things now. And we allow them to become part of our being in this moment and to ripple out and create shifts around us and to create this day ahead. We thank the universe for this blessing, and we thank ourselves for allowing it to come to fruition. And so it is.
And so it is.
be blessed. Thanks for watching the Morning Metaphysical Report, and we'll see you all again soon.
Namaste, everyone.